Okay, so, as you saw my video yesterday, this is going to be somewhat of my four-year special, or not four-year, two-year special. So, this is what I'm revealing to you guys. This is my project go-kart I bought a few months ago. I ripped the motor out of it, and I have another one waiting inside over there in the Lowe's home improving box. And let's just take around a look into the back. So this is actually a Murray go-kart. I looked it up, like model number and all that kind of stuff. It is a Murray go-kart. Now, the guy that I got it from, he sold it to me for a relatively cheap price. I thought I got a steal, and I did. This go-kart sold for like $3,000 or something stupid like that, and I got it for extremely cheap. So, what Douchebag did to fit the other engine that he threw into this thing, which is Predator 212, same engine that I got, that I'm gonna throw in this thing. Douchebag, freaking, look what he did. He cut these things. I'm not sure exactly why he did that instead of, like, retrofitting this and then, like, moving that and all that kind of stuff. Instead of cutting all this out. Because I'm having problem fitting a torque converter on this thing because of that. Just because that guy did all that crap. So, this Murray go-kart has a seatbelt, of course. I don't know if I'm going to use that because it doesn't really fit. This is the new project thing that I'm going to be working on for the next few videos over the summertime so I can show you guys. So, me and my friend, Will, found these things out in the woods, out of a table. And look where they fit over here. Hold on. Try it, like... Okay. So, this right here, this right here, I'm going to be bolting on to the side of the go-kart right here. This will act as an anti-rolling system, because as you can see, the go-kart's pretty high off the ground, for a go-kart anyway, and it's pretty bouncy. So, I don't want to be flipping over, because these tires right here, it doesn't have an independent suspension system, so it doesn't, it'll start to, like, roll as you turn. And I don't want to be flipping over, even though I do have a roll cage. I don't know if this is going to keep me safe. But the good thing is I have an engine that is waiting inside of there. For some reason, at Harbor Freight, when I opened the box, it says a 7-horsepower Predator engine instead of 6.5. So I'm not entirely sure what that's all about, but I have my throttle cable right here that I took out. But let me get inside the go-kart for you guys. Sorry guys, I'm a little bit barefoot. So this is inside of the go-kart, pretty good. I did adjust this throttle cable right here because I adjusted it on the actual engine itself, and it'll go down further. So that means more throttle, number one, faster. Most likely, that engine over there, once I'm through with it, is probably going to make around 8 horsepower. I don't know what that would be to the wheels because of the torque converter and how big the fat tires in the back are. So, probably be about 5 horsepower to the wheels. I'm not sure. But I have this, like, this is an aftermarket steering wheel. I don't know where they got it. Probably, like, Go Power Sports or something. These front tires right here, they are so small. I'm going to be replacing these with some tires that I found at Harbor Freight. They're about not that much bigger, but they will go along with the paint scheme because originally I wanted to get a go-kart and just throw a different engine on the thing. But since this is a go-kart, basically, I'm throwing a different engine on it. And I didn't like the color of this thing. I don't really like this green that much. So I'm going to be painting it blue, keeping the white. So it'll be a blue and white go-kart. I'm going to be getting some of some coilovers from Go Power Sports. Surprisingly, they're only like $20 for a set of them, so it'd be about $40 for the entire go-kart, which is not bad, and it'll give me a lower, lower center of gravity since it'll be lower to the back. A little bit higher to the front, so it'll keep the weight distribution even. And this thing will be pretty awesome because these coilovers, they're great and all, but honestly, I would rather have coilovers that are a little bit lower, number one, and a lot stronger than these are, because these are known to break. But they're good. And also, they are adjustable coilovers as well. But it's the guy that I got it from has been sitting outside, so those are rusted out. They're not going to move. But hopefully you guys enjoyed this. If you're wondering what that is, that's just a little filler for a little gas can that I had. Like, not a gas can, but it's going to be used as one. And it has, like, this little pump thing on it. And what that'll be used for is if I get stranded on the, like, in the woods or something, I can have, like, a little cable that's running through down here, and it comes up, and it'll pour into the gas thing. I'd probably keep, like, a gallon in there. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Sorry it's a quick, short, like, not the greatest video I've ever made, but this will be a fun project go-kart, and I'll definitely take many videos of this go-kart once it's all finished. I'll see all of you guys in the next video. Most likely going to be a build video on this thing. I'm not entirely sure. I have to go to Home Depot so I can try to make an engine plate, like retrofit one. And I'll see all of you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.